Hello and welcome to our guide on building a personal loan app. If you are an entrepreneur looking to break into the fintech space, you have made a smart decision by watching this video. Creating a personal loan app like Wicket, Chime, MoneyLion or Dave is a fantastic SaaS product idea that can significantly impact the financial industry. We are going to provide you with a step-by-step guide on how to build a money lending app, making the process clearer and more manageable. By the end of this video, you'll have a solid understanding. Let's dive right in. First, let's take a look at some of the popular personal loan apps out there. Apps like Lending Club, Sofi, Upstart, and Prosper have set high standards in the market. These loan apps offer seamless user experiences, quick loan approvals, and robust security features. When you are creating your micro loan app, aim to match or exceed these standards to compete effectively in the personal finance app market. Now, before jumping into the app development, there are some prerequisites you need to have in place. Number one, market research. This involves understanding of your target audience, their needs, and the competition. Think of it as preparing for a road trip. You need to know where you're going and what you'll encounter on the way. Use tools like surveys and focus groups to gather insights and make informed decisions in your app development process. Number two, regulatory compliance. Financial app needs to adhere to strict regulations to protect user data and ensure fair practices. Imagine it as building a house. You need to follow building codes to ensure safety and legality. Research the financial regulations in your target region to avoid any legal issues. Number three, technical stack. Your technical stack is like the foundation of your house. Popular choices for credit advance app include React Native for a smooth cross-platform front-end, Node.js for a scalable back-end, and database like MongoDB for reliable data storage. These stacks ensure your app can handle high traffic and provide a seamless user experience. Next, let's talk about the business model for your personal loan app. Your app can generate revenue through various methods. Number one, interest rates. Charge interest rate on loan provided like bank does. Number two, origination fees. A fee for processing the loan similar to a service fee. Number three, late payment fees. Charge fees for late payment as a penalty. Number four, subscription model. Offer premium features for subscription fees, much like Netflix does for entertainment content. With the groundwork laid, let's move to the personal loan app development steps. Here are a step-by-step guide. Number one, conceptualization. Define your app's unique value proposition. What makes your app different from a Lending Club or Sofi? For example, you might offer faster approval time or lower interest rate for specific demographics. Number two, wireframing. Create a wireframe of your app. Think of it as sketching out blueprint of your house. Tools like Figma or Sketch are excellent for this purpose. They help you visualize the app's layout and flow before you start building. Number three is UI/UX design. Design an intuitive user interface. Prioritize user experience to ensure ease of use. Your app should be as easy to navigate as a well-designed website. Users should find it simple to apply for loan, check their status, and make payments. Number four is backend development. Set up your server, database, and APIs. Ensure your backend can handle secure transaction and data encryption. This is the engine of your car. It needs to be robust and reliable. Number five is front-end development. Develop the user interface and integrate it with the backend services. Ensure the UI is responsive and works smoothly on various devices. This is the body of your car. It needs to look good and function well. Step number six is integration of the key features. Here, you can implement user authentication. Secure login via OTP, biometrics, or OAuth happens here. Think of this as the security system of your house. Second is the loan calculator. Allow user to calculate potential loan amounts and interest rates. It's like a budgeting tool that helps user plan their finances. Number third is credit scoring. Integrate the credit bureaus to assess user credit worthiness. This is similar to a background check, ensuring users are eligible for loans. Fourth is payment gateway. Securely process transactions using services like Stripe or PayPal. This is the cashier handling all monetary transactions securely. Fifth, push notification. Inform user about loan status, due date, etc. Think of this as reminders, keeping user informed and engaged. Now, the step number seven, conduct thorough testing. Unit testing, integration testing, and user acceptance testing. This is like a test drive. ensuring everything works smoothly before the final launch. And step number 8 in the development process includes the security. Implement robust security measures. Use SSL TLS for data transmission and ensure compliance with PCI DSS standards. This is like installing a high-tech alarm system in your house. Finally, let's discuss the launch process. Number 1, beta testing. Release a beta version to a small group of users. Gather feedback and make necessary adjustments. This is like having a housewarming party to get initial impressions. Number 2 is marketing strategy. Develop a marketing plan. Use social media, SEO, and partnerships to promote your app. It's like putting up advertisement for your new product. Number 3 is launch. Release your app on platform like Google Play Store and App Store. Ensure you have strong customer support system in place. Think of this as opening your store to the public. And number 4 is post-launch. Continuously monitor user feedback, update your app to fix bugs and add new features. Use analytics tool to track user behavior and app performance. It's like maintaining and upgrading your house over the time. And there you have it, a comprehensive guide to building your personal loan app. By following these steps and focusing on key features, you can create an app that stands out in the competitive fintech market. If you need professional help, IdeaSure is here to assist you. Click on the link in the description to book a free consultation call. If you found this guide helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more content on building successful SaaS products.